What are we doing, folks? We are going into the post-game for Let's Go Play Pokemon with Professor Chime. And this time around, we have some cool stuff that we can work with. We gotta get through some of this extra wording here. Sugar's gonna talk to us about the rumors about a super strong Pokemon. So, we're gonna go Mewtwo hunting. Because that's always fun. Mom doesn't say anything new. She just gives you a little encouragement and moves on. So we're gonna powerhouse through this. The world has been expanded, including the fact that I can fly into the sky with my Charizard. If I had a Dragonite, I would totally be flying on that, though. Master Trainers. Head to Viridian Forest. I will say the Pikachu trainer that he's talking about there is ridiculously difficult. So we're going to take Charizard out. And then we're going to fly to Cerulean City. Alright, so there's a coach there, which is actually pretty tough. Alright, so flying on Charizard is really cool, except the only way to make him stop is to line him up here. And the best place would probably be here. No. Here. It's hard to tell, unfortunately. So we're gonna hope for the best. And then you have to return him to the Pokeball. When you do that, it comes down. Cool, PP Max. That is an awesome little item. So he actually gives you a TM. I'm gonna come back for him because we're going Mewtwo hunting today. Not PP Max, where are you? I think it's under Power Pocket. So it optimally raises the maximum PP of a selected move that has been learned. So it brings it up to the highest possible amount that it can be. That's really useful for something like Pikachu, for instance, for his Zippy Zap or any of those kind of special moves. We're gonna hold on to it for the time being, though, because we might end up seeing something that we want to use it on. Alright, so one thing I do want to do, going into the Mewtwo battle, they treat it very similarly to the raids in Pokemon Go, which is cool. There's nothing wrong with that, except Mewtwo just devastates, and you're on a timer. So we're gonna move Mew to the front. He's a level 70. You have to take him down first. And then you have, so long to be able to do other stuff. Afterwards, which is fine. But the issue. Oh, another PP Max. That's always good. Let's see if there's any items over here. So you have to take him down from his level 70, basically, throne. 100% first. And then you can try to catch him. In our case, we have a Master Ball. So it's fine. It's no big deal. I hear there is a second Master Ball somewhere in here. Oh, well, that's cute. It's a little Poliwag in the water. That's adorable. Right on. I'm gonna go Pokemon hunting in here. They're all high level, like 50-something in here, too. I think we can go here. And... ooh, that was a Rhyhorn that popped up underneath me. Yeah, level 52 Rhyhorn. We're definitely gonna do some training in the Cerulean Cave when the time comes. Today, we're going to make our way around Cerulean Cave. We just caught ourselves a second Master Ball in the game. So, that's awesome. There's a Psyduck there hanging out. Well, we also got ourselves a Dome Fossil. We actually got the Helix Fossil from Mount Moon, and we got ourselves the Dome Fossil while hunting for a Master Ball. It's in the upstairs portion of Cerulean Cave. Check out my other video if you want to learn any more about that. Otherwise, we are on our way to Mewtwo, and what I assume is several soft resets. Mewtwo is hard. Alright, so, he's up on this island that we just passed. Alright, you can see him there. We are going to get a picture here. We're gonna save. And then we're gonna get a picture staring him down. Cool. I think this is the way to go. We're gonna hit it up. I moved, just so you know, Mew to the front of the party. Mew is gonna have the heaviest hits on him, probably. Honestly, Gengar would be really the best place to start. He's going to basically one-hit kill Gengar, but I'll be able to get my Dark Pulse in first. So we're gonna try that. Okay. So this is a timed battle. They treat it like a raid battle in Pokemon Go, which means that you have to battle it first on a timer, and then catch it. In our case, we now have two Master Balls, so I am okay with that. Shadow Ball. Oh, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt. Ah. Super effective. Ah, oh, that was rough. Starting first thing. He's going to hurt Pikachu pretty badly. So we're gonna hope that we can do it here. Okay, so our best bet would be to zippy zap it. Alright, cool. Critical hit, gonna use Psychic, one hit knockout. Problem is he's a level 70 and I'm not near there yet. So, I wanna use Blastoise because I wanna see if I can scald him before he takes out Blastoise. And a burn would be very good here. Amnesia, that's good, that's good. Gonna try to scald him. Didn't do a lot of damage, but he's burned, and that's the important part. Cool. Alright. So we're going to use Bite. Alright. He's gonna use Psychic. It's gonna probably take out Blastoise. Yeah, one hit knockout. burned, and that's the important part for all of this. We're going to use Charizard here. And we're gonna make him Mega Evolve Y. And then we're going to use Thinking Dragon Pulse will be the best bet. So it's gonna raise its stats, and that's all that I really care about there. Just hope that it... No, he knocked him out first thing. Alright, but he's burned. Alright, so next Pokemon is gonna be Hitmonlee. He's going to be fodder Pokemon, unfortunately. Sorry, Hitmonlee. And then we're going to go to Bag. And do a max revive on, I guess, Pikachu. Psychic's gonna knock out Hitmonlee immediately. Full on. Super effective. Fainted. Sorry, Hitmonlee. I knew it was gonna happen. Alright, so he's going to restore himself, or recover himself. We're going to use Mew. Because he does have Dark Pulse. Actually, Shadow Ball would be a much better thing here. So, recovers half of his health. In one fell swoop. Which means that if we knock him below half health, he's going to use it every time without fail. We just have to keep him busy as much as possible. Shadow Ball. Alright, I'm just glad that he's not gonna get rid of his burn, but he does use his psychic, and it is killer here. Alright, so it's gonna burn him, it's gonna drop his special defense. Okay, hurt by burn, and he's gonna want to use recover, so that'll allow me to sneak and do a max potion here. Because he's going to totally do a recover. Yep, without fail, every time. But he gets burned. And we lost our 5 minutes. So, we have to, unfortunately, go out of the game. And close software. And then try again. So we're just recording the whole thing here, which means that we're going to cut out some of this, I'm sure. Left off. I'm going to leave Mew in the front of this because I think this will be a good thing to work with. I just gotta hope that Blastoise can burn it again. We're gonna put... Actually, you know, let's put Hitmonlee... No. Gengar up front. Gengar up front made sense. Unfortunately, he's a one-hit knockout, but if he can get a attack in place before Mewtwo does, unfortunately he won't, but if he does, then it'll do some damage before he gets knocked out. Psychic's gonna knock out Gengar first thing. Now we're gonna move over to use next Pokemon, Pikachu. The order we did in was good, we just, it failed, unfortunately. And what we need is Splishy Splash, though. No, not at that point. Ooh, toughed it out. So I'll get a little damage in. Can't rely on that, though. Okay. Well, I know that Mewtwo's gonna be first, so we're going to do a max revive on Gengar. And he uses Psychic to take out Pikachu. Sorry, Pikachu. Who's next Pokemon? It's gonna be Blastoise now. It's all about strategy or having level 70 Pokemon. Alright, let's hope Scald takes... that's not gonna be good. Oh, okay. Thank you, Blastoise. It did not take. That was our hope there. We're gonna try Scald again, but he's gonna use Psychic and take him out. That was the match. Without Burn, there's no way that we're gonna take him out. Charizard, I guess. And I guess we're gonna do Mega Axe and Flamethrower. Maybe it'll burn him. If it even gets an attack off on him. Our issue is we're just not high enough level for this, unfortunately. Mew. Mew can at least hold his own for a few moves. Shadow Ball. Yeah, it takes some 3 hits to take out Mew. Super effective. Uses Amnesia, which raises his special defense. Now he's going to use Recover. Yeah, Shadow Ball. Yeah, he's going to use Shadow Ball here. Recover up. Hey, man. Okay. Landed a crit. Where was that earlier? And he used Psychic, which means he's going to use Recover in the next move here. He knows he has 20 seconds. But Gengar... Come on, can we do it? Can we do it? He used that Amnesia, so maybe... Maybe we did this. Maybe. We did it. We did it. Oh. All right. Now let's get Mewtwo with a Master Ball. We have two of them. Yes. Ready, set. It's an immediate thing. Oh, he knocks it away. That's cute. And too bad. Get in there. Yes! We have done it. 2100 experience points. Gengar's the only one that leveled up because everyone else was toast. Oh, that was on the nose. We got Mewtwo. Ugh. All right. Well, we have Mewtwo. What does Pikachu have to say? Looking at the Pokeball you used as if it wants to play with what's inside. Wants to play with Mewtwo. Pikachu wants to play with Mewtwo.
As always, like and subscribe. Don't forget to check out my other videos. As always, stay cool, everyone. Have a great day.